Cancer is a large group of diseases that can start in almost any organ or tissue of the body when abnormal cells grow uncontrollably, go beyond their usual boundaries to invade adjoining parts of the body, and spread to other organs. These rapidly growing cells may cause tumors. They may also disrupt the body's regular function. The latter process is called metastasizing and is a major cause of death from cancer. A neoplasm and malignant tumor are other common names for cancer. Cancer is the second leading cause of death globally, accounting for an estimated 9.6 million deaths, or 1 in 6 deaths, in 2018. Lung, prostate, colorectal, stomach, and liver cancer are the most common types of cancer in men, while breast, colorectal, lung, cervical, and thyroid cancer are the most common among women. The cancer burden continues to grow globally, exerting tremendous physical, emotional, and financial strain on individuals, families, communities, and health systems. Many health systems in low- and middle-income countries are least prepared to manage this burden, and large numbers of cancer patients globally do not have access to timely quality diagnosis and treatment. In countries where health systems are strong, survival rates of many types of cancers are improving, due to accessible early detection, quality treatment, and survivorship care. The main cause of cancer is mutations, or changes to the DNA in your cells. Genetic mutations can be inherited. They can also occur after birth as a result of environmental forces. These external causes, called carcinogens, which include physical carcinogens like radiation and ultraviolet light, chemical carcinogens like cigarette smoke, alcohol, air pollution, and contaminated food and drinking water, biological carcinogens like viruses, bacteria, and parasites. According to World Health Organization, about 33% of cancer deaths may be caused by tobacco, alcohol, high body mass index, low fruit and vegetable consumption, and not getting enough physical activity. According to a 2017 review, exposure to air pollution, exposure to radiation, unprotected exposure to UV light, such as sunlight, infection by certain viruses including H. pylori, human papillomavirus, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, HIV, and the Epstein-Barr virus, which causes infectious mononucleosis. The risk of developing cancer also increases with age. In general, the risk of developing cancer appears to increase until the age of 70 to 80. Cancers are named for the area in which they begin and the type made of, even if they spread to other parts of the body. For example, a cancer that begins in the lungs and spreads to the liver is still called lung cancer. There are also several clinical terms used for certain general types of cancer. Carcinoma is a cancer that starts in the skin or the tissues that line other organs. Sarcoma is a cancer of connective tissues such as bones, muscles, cartilage, and blood vessels. Leukemia is a cancer of the bone marrow, which creates abnormal blood cells. Lymphoma and myeloma are cancers of the immune system. Esophageal cancer, breast cancer, and pancreaticobiliary cancer. Lumps or growths on the body. Unexplained weight loss. Fever, tiredness and fatigue. Pain. Night sweats. Changes in digestion. Changes in skin. Cough. Normal cells in your body grow and divide. Each one has a life cycle determined by the type of cell. As cells become damaged or die off, new cells take their place. Cancer disrupts this process and causes cells to grow abnormally. It's caused by changes or mutations in the cell's DNA. These extra cells can divide uncontrollably, causing tumors to form. The DNA in each cell has instructions that tell the cell what to do and how to grow and divide. Mutations occur frequently in DNA, but usually cells correct these mistakes. When a mistake is not corrected, a cell can become cancerous. Mutations can cause cells that should be replaced to survive instead of die, and new cells to form when they're not needed. These extra cells can divide uncontrollably, causing tumors to form. Tumors can cause health problems, depending on where they grow in the body. Not all tumors are cancerous. Benign tumors are non-cancerous and do not spread to nearby tissues. Malignant tumors are cancerous and can invade other parts of the body. Some cancer cells can also spread through the bloodstream or lymphatic system to distant areas of the body. This is called metastasis. Cancers that have metastasized are considered more advanced than those that have not. Metastatic cancers are often harder to treat and more fatal. Cancer is more likely to respond to effective treatment when identified early, resulting in a greater probability of surviving as well as less morbidity and less expensive treatment. Early detection is when cancer is found in its early stages. This can increase the effectiveness of treatment and lower the mortality rate. Screening aims to identify individuals with abnormalities suggestive of a specific cancer or precancer who have not developed any symptoms and refer them promptly for diagnosis and treatment. Early diagnosis identifies symptomatic cancer cases at the earliest possible stage. Mammograms to test for breast cancer are recommended for women ages 45 and older, but you may choose to begin screenings at age 40. Some screenings, such as for cervical cancer and prostate cancer, may be done as part of routine exams. Screenings for lung cancer may be performed regularly for those who have certain risk factors. Skin cancer screenings may be performed by a dermatologist if you have skin concerns or are at risk of skin cancer. While recognizing cancer warning signs may help people with cancer seek diagnosis and treatment, some cancers may be harder to detect early and may not show symptoms until the later stages. Treatment options include surgery, cancer medicines, and/or radiotherapy, administered alone or in combination. A multidisciplinary team of cancer professionals recommends the best possible treatment plan based on tumor type, cancer stage, clinical and other factors. The choice of treatment should be informed by patients' preferences and consider the capacity of the health system. Localized treatment usually involves using treatments like surgery or local radiation therapy at a specific area of the body or tumor. Surgery removes as much of the cancer as possible. Surgery is often used in combination with some other therapy in order to make sure all of the cancer cells are gone. Radiation therapy done inside of your body using radioactive sources is called brachytherapy. While radiation therapy using an external source targeting the tumor within the body is called external beam radiation. Systemic treatment, systemic drug treatments, such as chemotherapy, targeted therapy, and immunotherapy, can affect the entire body. Chemotherapy is a form of aggressive cancer treatment that uses medications that are toxic to cells to kill rapidly dividing cancer cells. It may be used to shrink the size of a tumor or the number of cells in your body and lower the likelihood of the cancer spreading. Immunotherapy uses your body's own immune system to attack cancer cells. These therapies help your antibodies recognize the cancer, so they can use your body's natural defenses to destroy cancer cells. Hormone therapies removes or blocks hormones that fuel certain cancers to stop cancer cells from growing. This therapy is a common treatment for cancers that may use hormones to grow and spread, such as certain types of breast cancer and prostate cancer. Targeted therapy is a type of cancer treatment. It uses drugs to target specific genes and proteins that help cancer cells survive and grow. Targeted therapy can affect the tissue environment that cancer cells grow in, or it can target cells related to cancer growth, like blood vessel cells. Targeted therapy can treat many different types of cancer. It can also be used in combination with other cancer treatments, such as chemotherapy. Currently, not all cancers have targeted therapies available, but this is a rapidly growing area of research and many new targeted therapies are being studied in clinical trials. Palliative care involves relieving health symptoms associated with cancer, such as trouble breathing and pain. Different cancer treatments are often used together to remove or destroy as many cancerous cells as possible. Palliative care, which focuses on improving the quality of life of patients and their families, is an essential component of cancer care. Stem cells are special cells produced by bone marrow that can turn into different types of blood cells. A stem cell or bone marrow transplant replaces damaged blood cells with healthy ones. It can be used to treat conditions affecting the blood cells, such as leukemia and lymphoma. Between 30% and 50% of cancer deaths could be prevented by modifying or avoiding key risk factors and implementing existing evidence-based prevention strategies. Prevention also offers the most cost-effective long-term strategy for the control of cancer. Modifying or avoiding the following key risk factors can help prevent cancer. Avoid tobacco use, including cigarettes and smokeless tobacco. Maintain a healthy weight. Eat a healthy diet with plenty of fruit and vegetables. Limit alcohol use. Get vaccinated against hepatitis B and human papillomavirus. Reduce exposure to ultraviolet radiation. Avoid urban air pollution and indoor smoke from household use of solid fuels. Get regular medical care. Cancer is a group of serious diseases that are caused by genetic changes in your cells. Abnormal cancer cells may divide rapidly and form tumors. Risk factors like smoking, drinking alcohol, a lack of physical activity, an unhealthy diet, having a high body mass index, and catching certain viruses and bacteria may contribute to developing cancer. Screenings may help detect cancer early when it is easier to treat. The treatment plan and outlook for people with cancer can depend on the type of cancer, the stage at which it is diagnosed, and their age and general health. If you want to watch more videos about health, make sure you subscribe to our channel.